shades.
Together.
We will find a place.
Together.
Where there's so much space. Rustling just to things, ready to be too.
So that's what
we are gonna do.
What we're gonna do is go away.
Life is peaceful there.
Go away.
Back in the open air.
Go
lies in your minds. We'll blow away. It's easy to believe they're here to stay. You won't find them standing in your way.
Oh, in a little while from now, if I'm not feeling any less sour, I promise myself to treat myself and visit a nearby tower. And climbing to the top will throw myself off in an effort to make it clear to whoever what it's like when you're shattered, left standing in the lodge at a church where people say, my God, that's tough, she stood him up, no point in us remaining, we may as well go home, as I did on my own, alone again, naturally.
To think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to, well, it wouldn't do, the role I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God and His mercy. If He really does exist, why did He desert me? In my hour of need, I truly am indeed alone again, naturally.
Seems to me that there are more hearts broken in the world that can be mended, left unattended. What do we do?
What do we do? Never wishing to hide the tears.
And at 65 years old, my mother, God rest her soul, couldn't understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken.
And when she passed away, I cried and cried all day.